Hello, Lolo. So what have you got for breakfast this morning? And is it yummy?
Yeah.
What are you having after that?
Toast with Nutella on it.
Let's hope we have some.
And then a pastry.
A pastry. You're tired, aren't you? It's been a tiring holiday, hasn't it?
What have you had?
What have I got? I've got the same. I've got sausage, bacon. I've gone for some, what do you call them, Neen?
Pomme de terre.
Yeah,
potatoes.
Yeah, today I'm having scrambled egg. I only really like scrambled egg if it's made by my own hands.
Hang on, I'm going to taste it. It's made with cream.
Is it?
Yeah.
So, we're actually coming to the hotel this morning for breakfast on the last day. We're quite gutted we've not been in before, haven't we?
Yeah, it's really, really good choice. Lots of cold choices, loads of pastries, loads of cheeses, breads, fruit coming out your ears, yogurt coming out your ears. I'm going over for a yogurt in a minute.
Rock and roll.
Sushi, potatoes, and meat,
and everything.
And
everything is well done. So like, if you don't like your food well done, you come in and you'd probably be a little bit disappointed. But if you like your food well done, which we do, it's perfect. We'll be just about to meet
Mickey Mouse.
Are you excited?
Yeah.
Why?
Because it's the best buddy.
Okay, so this is our last day. We've been for breakfast. We are just holding our luggage in the luggage hold area. We're about to check out, make some phone calls, and got our timetable and everything ready for the magical shuttle, which will take us to the airport. All in all, we've had a really, really good time. Really, really gutted to be going home. Really looking forward to my mum's birthday tonight and Blackpool air show tomorrow. Seeing family, we've got family over at the moment, my auntie and uncle, so that'll be nice catching up with them.
Me? Yeah. Alright. Looking forward to the air show?
Yeah. I think I'm just going to have to go back to Google on that. Feel some spots of rain.
Gentlemen, I give you 29 squadrons, Typhoon, Black Lieutenant Ryan Lawton, roll higher! Sorry, did I tell you about the noise?
Let's scaled up radio controlled models designed by two Germans, Thomas and Matthias Stryker. And Chris, looking around him.
So,
get yourself ready for a high power, close couple of aerobatics. Team leader, Ben Murphy. Let me just read you some of what he's done. Gulf War 2003, Afghanistan, Harrier, 1,000 hours in the logbook, Red Arrows, 2006, and was the commanding officer 2010-2011, joined the Blades 2015.
And as they get into Carlin, each of their formations has a name. You'll get to know this later on when you see nine bright red jets. Put your hands together as we welcome the Royal Air Force Aerobatic Team to Red down now, they've slowed down to 150 miles per hour at the top of the loop. As the noses go through the horizon, they're pointing vertically downwards again. They're accelerating up through 200, 300, 400 miles per hour in nine arrow formation. They'll twist this over the sea now. And the front of nine arrow is Red One. He is one of the debut Montenegro. That's his third and final year as the team leader of the Red Arrows. His background is as a hawk flying instructor.
So it's not about that, I'm editing the sound out anyway. I'm just going to do it to music.
He first joined the Red Arrows back in 2009.
Oh yeah!
In this left-hand turn now, you'll see Reds 4, 5, 8 and 9 have moved forward. Aveem, Reds 2 and 3. Reds 6 and 7 are tucked in behind. Again, the closest parts of these jets around 6 feet or 2 metres apart, with some more in white and blue, and they present Phoenix!